Welcome all, and it's a great privilege to be a part of this online TOT workshop. So I hope my screen is visible to all. My session for today is regarding the resources for AOP trainers. The World Health Organization notes that one of the most significant barriers to deliver and improve eye care is due to the lack of well-trained AOP. So this in turn requires expert trainers to develop competent AOP. So we've been talking in this online TOT workshop about how to engage or how to become effective AOP trainers. So this session will include a demonstration of AuroSiksha, which is an online portal for AOP training resources. So AuroSiksha, to talk about AuroSiksha, it's developed based on a competency-based approach. So to talk about what is a competency-based approach is that it's a way of training which focuses on the learner, which is learner-centric, and it has a direct application to the real-world practice. And it is clear in its objectives, and its desired performance outcomes are expected of the trainee. And it is also engaged in giving feedback on the progress of the training. So the resources in AuroSiksha is based on the competency-based approach. So today's session, I'm just briefing about the AOP resource library, AuroSiksha's library resource and the learning management system. So I would go on with the AOP resource library feature first. So this is the homepage of AuroSiksha, and I would show the library feature of AuroSiksha first. You would find all the listed competencies, what we call. We nearly have around 105 competencies uploaded in AuroSiksha library. We have the both skill and knowledge-based competencies. So I would just show each one from knowledge and the skill-based competencies. So first I would like to show a demo of a CTM, what we call a basic resource or a lesson in AuroSiksha. So regarding the anatomy and physiology of cornea, a CTM, a knowledge-based CTM on AuroSiksha, we have a description or about the competency, which describes what it handles, so what the session has. And we also have the learning objectives, what is expected of the student to learn at the end of the CTM, and the resources in the CTM. So the session is on resources for AOP trainers. So we have the teaching and learning resources in each CTM. So I would go on to the teaching slides part. So this requires a sign-in user, a library user can view all this. So teaching slides regarding this CTM, we have the title slide and the learning objectives. Like every, since it's a competency-based learning, we have the learning objectives listed at the end of the session, what the trainee will be able to learn. And we have a think-through session in it. So basically, everyone, library user on AuroSiksha can access freely all these resources. So this is about the teaching slides. We have anatomy and the physiology part below. So next, I would like to show the teacher's guide, which listed the teaching. It has the screenshots of the teaching slides and what the trainer is expected to deliver in class. So basically we have what is the prerequisite competency that the trainee should know before they come for the session. So in order to learn anatomy and physiology of cornea, the trainee should have to prerequisite anatomy, physiology of eye and conjunctiva competencies to learn this. So basically in trainer's guide, we provide all the screenshots of what you saw here and the notes section where what the trainer is expected to talk in the class. Next, I would move on to the question bank resource, for the AOP trainer. We have a few questions listed already from taken from the CTM. So this would benefit when they have to conduct offline assessments to the trainees and so on. So this PDF has questions related to anatomy and physiology of cornea. All the bolded are the answers. And so each CTM is built with a teaching slide, teacher's guide, and a question bank. So in this knowledge-based CTM, we also provide learning resource, which is meant for the trainee. So trainee gets access to the handout, which is more or like a student's note, which has the content from the CTM, and they have small activities and questions for them, and even a glossary and definition terms regarding the CTM. So this will be handover to the trainees for the session. So they have small activities, and we also provide the Tamil glossary for each medical term and so on. Next, we also have an online assessment for the trainee to take up in each CTM. So only thing they have to do is they'll have to, the library user has to sign up and get access to this. After choosing, they'll have to save and submit the assessment. So this is regarding the knowledge-based CTM that I shown you. So next, I would like to show a demo of a skill-based CTM. So in skill-based competency, we have the same learning and teaching resources like I showed you before, the teaching slides, teacher's guide, and handout. In addition, we also have the lab session and observation session guidelines also. So here, in addition, since it's a skill-based CTM, we also have a skill evaluation tool, a skill evaluation checklist to assess the anterior segment examination. So I'm taking the demo of the CTM. So we've been looking at sessions previous day about the formative skill assessment and so on. So we all the skill-based CTM has a skill evaluation checklist where each step-by-step procedure is getting assessed for the trainee based on the scaling. So this is one additional resource in the skill-based CTM. And next I would like to show a lab session teacher's guide. So this is for the teacher on how to hand over or how to take a lab session, like what method to be followed to take a lab session for the trainee. So in a lab session, it is given like what the end of the session, what the trainee will be able to do, and the required materials to do this procedure, and the step-by-step demonstrations of each skill. So this will benefit the AOP trainer to handle the lab session very effectively. Next, I would move on to the observation teacher's guide. So this resource is built basically when after a lab session is over, the trainees are expected to go to the clinic and observe the skill. So for that session, what requires to be done? So this is a resource for the trainer to plan for the observation session. So they'll have to hand over the observation guidelines and log forms to the trainees and then ask them to go to the clinical areas, observe and document their findings. So related to this observation session, we give a log form to the learner, a trainee. So what they are expected to do in the observation session, and they are asked to note down what all they have observed, what all materials are required for the skill to be done, and they document the findings in this log form. So this is about the skill-based competency on oral siksha. So I would encourage you to sign up and explore more resources in this. I'm just showing each one from the skill and the knowledge base. Also, we have the resource type filters. So if you want to get access to the teaching guide alone, you can use these filters and just explore the resources. One such additional resource is the university exam paper we have on Aura Siksha. So we have uploaded all the MGR university question papers for DOA and DOT. So we have all the years question paper for the reference. So So this request to get access to the library, it's a free access of resource. So only thing you have to do is to sign up. So just a basic registration form that you usually do. So once you get signed up to this site, you get free access to all these resources. So I've just given a brief demo on the AOP resource library that Aura Siksha has. So next, I would like to move on to the learning management system of Aura Siksha. So in the learning management system, many of you would be familiar with what is an LMS. So learning management system is basically a student management system where a training institution can administer training through online methods. So in LMS, like, we have different roles. So I'm focusing on the teacher role of Aura Siksha LMS. So how a teacher gets access to the student management system, I'll just show you how. So this particular teacher, we would enroll them into Aura Siksha LMS, and they have a unique login through which they can get access to the Aura Siksha LMS. So this teacher A is being enrolled in such the below programs. So each program, like, we have number of competencies assigned to each program, sessions assigned, and we can see the number of AOP students assigned to this program. And this particular teacher A is assigned to all such programs below. So I would like to show how a session calendar appears for a teacher. So this is a view of the October calendar. And for today's session, there's a session schedule for teacher A. And only thing the teacher has to do is to log on to her LMS and click through the session calendar and go to the session. So it is a classroom session and has the session modules and session resources linked to it. It's all what you saw in the library. And addition to it, we have the AOP students assigned, and we also have a feature to mark attendance for that session. So if it is a physical classroom, like, you will just have to have a tab, or in a system, you'll just mark the attendance and save it. So this is about the session, classroom sessions. And one additional session is the skill assessment session. So in this particular Vision Technician program, I'm asking the students to be assessed for the skill called measuring visual acuity. So as a teacher, I want it, as an AOP trainer, I want them to get assessed for this particular skill. So we assign skill to this program, and the same students assigned to this program gets viewed here. And if suppose if the teacher A wants to assess Apurva, so she has to click through this. And we define what is called a minimum practice turn and successful turn required to complete this visual acuity. So we had a session yesterday about a skill assessment where a trainee is required to do 25 times a skill to practice it on live. So the same way, we define a turn criteria to be completed to say that this particular student is competent enough to perform this skill. So when we give assess, you see a digitized form of a checklist, skill assessment checklist on measuring visual acuity. So we all have the skill-based CTM having the same digitized checklist also. So only thing, this will be accessible through tabs, and it reduces much of the paperwork. So the trainer will have this on hand through a tab, and she will assess in a clinic where the trainee performs the skill. So this checklist has each stepwise, it grades like good, needs improvement, and not satisfactory and not applicable. So each step is graded this way. If a trainee performs the step very excellently, they are graded as good. And if she has to perform with much improvement, we give a needs improvement. And if suppose she misses a step, it's like a not satisfactory term. So this is how the skill is assessed through a digitized checklist. So once all this over, we have to save this form. And I would show you a report of how this looks later. So this is a skill assessed for Aarti, student Aarti by teacher A. So we have when the skill was performed and who assessed it and the percentage obtained by this particular student. So this you can see like reduces a lot of paperwork when it is being assessed online. So we find this red and green turn. So when teacher A assesses the student, if she scores any not satisfactory step, which is a zero turn, a zero step, she gets what is called a fail turn. So we expect her to get progress through the next turns. So we give her a repeat turn, which is like we define the minimum practice turn, so it will just give her an opportunity to improve eventually. So next time when she gets assessed by teacher A, she gets a 98% for this particular skill. So this is how a report looks for a completed skill assessment. So I would next move on to a live session of AOP trainers login. So this is what we, during the lockdown, we had the AOP teachers being, or the tutors or AOP employees being assigned a student to the skill certification program where they are considered as a student. So each teacher has a switch role feature where she can get switched to a student role where she gets assigned to programs where she has to take up sessions as a student. So this is one feature of Aura Siksha LMS. So I would show the feature like for the Mahajanani. She's a student now and she's a student in my Common Skills Refraction program. So for her, the dashboard looks like what are all the sessions assigned for her. So she's been assigned so many sessions and her test performance are listed here. And scrolling down, we see the competencies assigned to her and her skill practice report. So in this you find some are gray and some are green. All the green ones are completed by her and the gray ones are the incomplete turn. So this is how the dashboard of AOP trainer or student. So this feature is available on Aura Siksha where a trainer is also enrolled as a student through switch role. In addition to it, I would also, we have different roles on Aura Siksha LMS. So for the high level data, we can generate reports for how a program is done and how the performance can be tracked through the high level data. So this is a supervisor role in Aura Siksha LMS. So I would just go through, these are the reports available already in Aura Siksha LMS. So I'll just go through the skill competency report. So if I want to see the same program of my common skills refraction, so I would go through the program and I would select the location and see for each skill, like how many users have completed and not completed the skill. So this is a high level data, which is given, this role is given to the managers so that they can view the high level data of the completion in each program. So this lists the users who have completed and not completed the skill. So this was all about Aura Siksha LMS. So for, I would suggest the users to go and explore Aura Siksha library by signing up the form on Aura Siksha and log on to Aura Siksha. For any suggestions, you can contact through email aurasiksha@aravind.org. Thank you.